Welcome to Stump Your Friends, the game show where it's just as important to know your friends as it is to know the answers. So, let's meet our friends. Bringing rock music, MCU, and comedies to the board, it's Darrin.
I'm here to rock and roll and make some jokes, so...
So rock and roll we will.
So rock
with
and roll
vampires,
we will.
Shakespear, and bones, it's Sophie.
I'm here to take a bite out of this quiz.
And knowing a little something about World War II, aviation, and politics, it's Nick.
Vote for me to win, and you won't get anything. But I hope I will.
We do things a little differently here on Stump Your Friends. You've brought your topics of expertise, but your friends will be the ones who assign you your trivia topics. Then you've got 60 seconds to answer 5 questions, each one easier than the last, but also worth fewer points. And of course, unlike those other game shows, the point of Stump Your Friends is not to win, but instead to make sure you're not in last. Because whoever ends the game with the fewest points will receive a bright orange safety vest to caution the world that you are easily stumped. So, without further ado, let's start round one. All right, Sophie, you have been randomly chosen to give Darrin our first category.
I think a good first category to start Darrin off with would be... Let's start off with vampires, one of my favorite topics.
Okay. Vampires, Darrin, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. 5 questions, 1 minute, starts right now. The first published modern vampire story, The Vampire, was written by whom?
Lord Byron.
Ooh, we are looking for John Paul Dory.
Obviously, Darrin.
For 4 points, what is the term for a half-human, half-vampire hybrid like Blade or Alucard?
A daywalker.
That is correct. We'd also accept Dampier. For 3 points, what vampire film series features the characters Celine, Michael, and Lucian? 20 seconds left.
Underworld.
That is correct.
Okay.
For 2 points, who is the numbers obsessed vampire from the Muppets?
The Count.
Yes, that is correct. And for 1 point, what is the last name of Edward from Twilight? That is correct.
Damn.
Just under the wire there. Well done.
I can't believe your comedy Bang Bang listening got you Underworld.
Yeah, Len Wiseman likes to host a lot of sex parties, and that's all I know about him.
That's disgusting.
Okay.
You know that.
That's great. That's great to know. Thank you for that, Darrin. And hey, 10 points. That's not a bad way to start the round. And hey, Darrin, guess what? You're up.
Oh, boy.
Please assign a topic to Nick.
Oh, jeez.
Okay. Well, I feel like... the right way to go here would be to give Shakespear to Nick.
Okay. All right,
Shakespear, Nick, are you ready? 1 minute, 5 questions, starting right now.
Let's do this.
For 5 points, what play has the subtitle, Or What You Will?
Merry Wives of Windsor.
We are looking for 12th Night. So sorry. 4 points. How many acts are in a typical Shakespeare play?
4?
Ooh, so close. It's 5. For 3 points, what is Romeo's last name?
Capulet.
It is Montagu. That is Juliet. For 2 points, what English town has the birthplace of William Shakespeare?
Oh, no. Avon? Stratford-on-Avon.
Stratford-upon-Avon. Yes, that's right. Yes. For 1 point, what tragedy is called the Scottish play?
Macbeth.
That's correct. 3 points, that is not... terrible?
Not terrible. I knew it was more than 3, and then I was like 4, but then it was 5, and then... I'm disappointed in myself.
Much ado about nothing. We're like, much ado about 3 points.
Lord.
Get out of here.
Well, don't worry, because maybe now it is your time to shine. Please assign Sophie.
Like a, felt like a loaded presentation. I'm going to assign Sophie Aviation.
Ooh, all right.
Okay, Aviation.
Let me stretch my
How much you know about Aviation? 1 minute, five questions. Here we go, Sophie, starting right now. Who was the first black woman to earn a pilot's license?
I don't know, but she sounds cool.
Okay, I'll take pass. That as a pass. We are looking for Bessie Coleman. For 4 points, what is the common name of the first supersonic commercial airplane?
Robert.
We're looking for Concorde, so sorry.
Close.
For 3 points, who famously flew the Spirit of St. Louis in 1927?
I'm gonna say one of the Wright brothers.
That is actually Charles Lindbergh.
Oh man, what happened to his baby?
For 2 points, what wide-body Boeing airliner was known as the first jumbo jet? 13 seconds
747?
Left. That is right, 747.
Yeah!
And for 1 point, what was the last name of the aviation pioneer brothers, Orville and Wilbur?
Right.
Yes! It is the Wright brothers. Well done. 3 points?
Hey.
Ain't so bad.
It was when I got 3 points. Everyone was crapping on me.
I mean, look, all I'm saying, you guys are tied. Tied for right. last place, and that's not where you want to be.
That's true, that's not where
okay.
I want to be.
If you'd framed the... If you'd framed the Spirit of St. Louis question as a true crime question, she would have got it immediately.
Yeah, who's what master of aviation got his baby tooketh? Pray thee, dost thou know the fate of the Lindbergh baby?
Rephrase the question and the language era.
Yes, please.
And then boom, it would have been easy.
10
easy
points
mode.
For Sophie.
Well, before we go to round two, let's take a look at those scores. With 10 points, it's Darrin.
Daywalker Darrin
Schultz. Daywalker Darrin Schultz up with 10 points and tied for last place. Not where you want to be. With 3 points each, it's Nick and Sophie. What do you have to say for yourselves?
I knew.
I'll repeat myself.
Ah, yes.
Hope that vest is big enough for two.
Hey-o. Talking smack pretty early. I don't know. A lot can change in round two, which works exactly like round one, except now. More pictures! Normally, last place would be able to start our assigning process, but considering that Nick and Sophie are tied, and Sophie started last time, let's go ahead and start with Nick. Nick, please assign a topic to Darrin.
Okay, I think Darrin is gonna get bones.
Bones. Okay, are you ready, Darrin?
I am ready for bones.
1 minute on the clock, and it starts. Right now, Darrin.
Okay.
What animal does this arm belong to?
A sea lion.
We will not accept that. So sorry. Moving on for 4 points. What is the red bone called?
That's a wishbone, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
It's a wishbone. 4 points. Well done. For 3 points, what bone is broken in this X-ray?
Is it the mandible?
That is correct, the mandible or jawbone. For 2 points, what human bone is this?
Oh, that's Adam's rib, of course.
That is correct, it's a rib. And for 1 point, what dinosaur's skeleton is this?
That's a three horn, or a triceratops.
Okay, we will take triceratops, yes.
I'm so frustrated by this.
Me too. Oh, I'm very frustrated by this.
Would you guys have both gotten all of those?
I would have.
Well, you're the bones expert. I would hope so, Sophie.
I don't think I would have gotten seal, but I think I would have got the rest of them.
I'm so mad that wasn't a sea lion.
It was a very good guess. I will give you that. All right, Darrin, your job's not over.
Yeah.
It's time for you to assign a topic to Sophie.
Okay. I'm going to give Sophie Schwartz...
Just dox me, why don't you?
Comedies.
Comedies, okay. Well, a bold move, it seems, considering you're all in a comedy team. But we'll see how it goes. You've got 1 minute, Sophie. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Time starts Now, who is the man in this GIF?
Buster Keaton.
It is Buster Keaton. A 5-pointer. Well done. For 4 points, what movie is this?
Is that The Hangover? Crazy Rich Asians.
It is Crazy Rich Asians. For 3 points, what show is this?
That is Flight of the Conchords.
It is Flight of the Conchords. For 2 points, what movie's poster
that
is this?
That is Airplane.
It is Airplane. And for 1 point, what sitcom is this cast
photo? Oh my
photo
god,
from?
You guys. Is that Big Bang Theory? We're calling that a comedy.
As funny as it may not be, it is the Big Bang Theory. That's 11 points. Well done, Sophie. That was the best round yet for anybody?
First person to get a 5.
Wow, first person to get a 5-pointer. Well done.
Thank you, Darrin,
all
for
right.
the category.
I feel like Darrin is intentionally sabotaging me.
It may be, because there's only a few categories on the board left. And Sophie, please give Nick our final category for round two.
I will have to, although he is a man in his late 20s, early 30s, I will have to give Nick the MCU.
Okay. I'm going to assume that you don't know too much about the MCU, Nick.
It's the right choice, given what's here.
Let's find out.
All right.
1 minute on the clock for MCU right now.
What do we got?
What MCU movie is this Stan Lee cameo from?
This is a rude question. Ant-Man.
I'm so sorry. It is actually Captain America Civil War.
Of course. Obviously. FedEx.
For 4 points, what character does this actress play in the MCU?
Mary. I don't know.
We're looking for Okoye. This is from The Walking Dead, though. For 3 points, who is the actress in this image?
I see a red, an orange vest in my future. This is, of course, Charlize Theron.
No, it is not. It is Evangeline Lilly. For 2 points, this is the ending shot from what MCU movie?
Black Panther?
No, it is Captain Marvel. With 9 seconds left, what is this character's name?
I feel like this is like, I feel like it's gone from impossible to insultingly easy.
Hurry!
I ran out of time. I don't care.
You didn't get that point, Nikki.
I don't care.
You could have.
We're not gonna give you the point.
That's fine. No, that's fine. I'm fine with this.
I'm sorry, but was that a 0 point?
Yeah.
Round?
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, normally I stand behind not saying Tony Stark or Iron Man, but Nick, come on.
sometimes you get assigned a rough category by your friends. We like to call that a stump.
Oh, you've been stumped.
If a Nick falls in the forest, can anyone hear him stump?
I've never been more angry at the MCU than I am right now.
All right, before we go to the final question, let's take a look at those scores. Darrin up on top with 20 points. Wow, well done. Sophie in second with 14 points, and Nick with 3 points.
Yeah.
There's still time. There's still the final question, which is worth up to 15 points, Nick. This is your chance. And because you are in last place, you do get to assign our final category.
Okay. I think Darrin knows a lot about politics and rock and roll. I think Sophie might know some about politics and rock and roll as well, but I think I got him on World War II. So I gotta go World War II for my Hail Mary.
Okay, here we go. I'm pulling for you, Nick.
That's nice of you to say.
we've got our final category, so now we go to the big final question. Here's how it works. Each of our contestants will get 60 seconds to answer one final, very tough question on World War II. If they can answer it within 20 seconds, they can win up to 15 points. The longer they wait to answer, the more hints they'll get, but fewer points it will be worth. Final question in World War II.
This is for all the marbles.
Remember how this works, folks? Write it down, place it up, and that's how much you'll be eligible for. 60 seconds starts now. What was the operation code name for the naval phase of the Allied invasion of Normandy? All right. About 5 seconds left to get that first possible 15-pointer in. Let's see our first hint. It is also the name of a planet in our solar system. 10 seconds to get that. Oh, it looks like Nick and Sophie and Darrin have all put up an answer. But let's see that
final
hint.
Sealing my fate.
And let's see. This planet was named after the Roman god of the sea. Does anyone want to change their answer? 10 seconds left. It looks like they're holding true. Oh, okay. The answers are in. Nick, what did you put?
Getting the same points as everybody else, I'm sure. I put Neptune.
Neptune. Sophie?
That would be Mr. Neptune.
And Darrin?
Our good old friend, Mr. Neptune.
Okay, so it looks like with 10 points across the board for everybody, I think we know how this ends. But Darrin, up in first place with 30 points. Sophie, in second with 24 points. And I am so sorry, Nick.
You're not sorry.
I'm not. But I am excited to see Nick with 13 points. But more importantly, with a nice, bright orange vest. And that's that. Thank you so much for playing Stump Your Friends, folks. Remember, Darrin, Sophie, do not let Nick off easy. He's going to have to wear that, and you're going to take plenty of pictures and tag him with Easily Stumped on social media. And how did you do, viewers? If you were keeping track of your score, comment below and let us know how you did, and maybe we'll see you on the next Stump Your Friends.
My one consolation is that even if I had bothered to say Iron Man and known Neptune on the 15, I still would have come in last.